Hey, you. Yeah, you. I have something top secret for you this week, but you have to be able to keep it hush, hush, okay? I also have some news about GitHub Codespaces and placement policies for VMware. First though, I'd like to remind you to join our Discord server to discuss more cloud and get help with any questions that you might have about the cloud computing world. At ACG, we love cloud. And on Discord, we talk about all the clouds, including Azure. So come on over, we're friendly. Now on to the news. If you have a top secret product or place, would you name it top secret? Kind of defeats the purpose, doesn't it? Maybe a better name would have been obsolete cloud VMs or something. Anyway, Azure now offers the Azure Government Top Secret, a cloud service for government agencies that need to manage, well, top secret data. The Top Secret offering is launching with more than 60 services and the promise of more to come soon. So what does this actually mean, you might ask? It means the services offered under this top secret tier must adhere to the Intelligence Community Directive 503 and 705. Yes, these dictate risk mitigations for the data and the buildings, so the physical buildings of the data or where the data lives. The announcements also has some pretty diagrams of how much more secret top secret is than just plain old secret. And more stuff about how this will protect against bad people in the cybersecurity world. So, if you're in the need of top secret cloud computing, there's now a place for you. Just don't tell anyone. Shh. Remember Visual Studio Online? Not the DevOps product that is now Azure DevOps. The online version of the Microsoft IDE. You know, where you could use Visual Studio in the browser. And that was then renamed to Visual Studio Codespaces, and that's now called GitHub Codespaces. Yeah, thanks, Microsoft. Well, it is now in general availability, and Codespaces is essentially a VM that you get to run a developer environment on, which means you can configure it too. For the GA release, you can choose up to 32 cores of CPU power and 64 gigabytes of RAM, and that should make development and compiling breeze. And now, some news where I definitely understand every single thing. Absolutely. Placement policies for Azure VMware are now in public preview. These policies can define constraints for your SDDC clusters, which supports optimization and help mitigate the impact of maintenance operations and are created with a vSphere distributed resource scheduler. Apparently. Oh, SDDC is a solution software-defined data center, like a data center within a data center, I think. According to Microsoft, there are two basic types of these placement policies, VM to VM and VM to SDDC, which can each instruct the system where to place the VMs in VMware. So if you are into VMware on Azure, these new placement policies will give you more control of where the VMs are on the platform. And I totally know what all that meant. Are you going to use the new top secret services? Oh, wait, you can't tell me if you are. Blink twice for confirmation and leave a red envelope on the largest VM you can find, as well as clicking subscribe to the channel. That'll work. Now, if you like this video, give us a thumbs up as well. As we say on the A-Cloud Guru team, when we don't know what is top secret or not, and all we get are hidden signals in the clouds, seek and you shall cloud. So see you next week and keep being secret, cloud gurus.